Hello friends, welcome back to your UPSC. Today we are going to start with a new topic in human geography, that is the concept of quantitative regulation. So let's get started. So, quantitative regulation. Quantitative regulation, as the name suggests, quantitative regulation, it deals with the quantitative technique for understanding or studying or analyzing the geographical system. We can basically define quantitative regulation or quantitative technique as the application of statistical and mathematical techniques, theorems and proofs in understanding the geographical system. Okay, so in quantitative regulation, all the quantitative techniques like statistical methods, mathematical techniques, theorems and proofs are utilized, or they are applied to understand the geographical system. Now, this concept of statistical method, it was first introduced in geography in early 1950s, okay? Because as we know, our geographical system, it mainly consists of descriptive facts and descriptive analysis or descriptive statistics, okay? So now, there was introduction of some hypothesis, some testing, okay, they were used in the quantitative revolution in geographical system, okay. Now, during this quantitative revolution, many methods were used, like we have chi-square method, bivariate regression analysis, then we had general linear model. So, we have general linear model. This model, it was mostly used by the geographers, okay? The main boom or the main growth in the discipline of quantitative revolution or in the field of quantitative revolution can be seen during 1963, when a Canadian geographer, he was named I. Burton, okay? He published a research paper. And this research paper was named as the Quantitative Revolution and Theoretical Geography. Okay, so this research, after the publishing of this research paper, quantitative revolution, it gained attention of various geographers, many geographers all around the world. And it was during this time, this quantitative revolution, it experienced a great boom. Okay. Now, in this quantitative revolution, we use statistical method and mathematical techniques, okay? So, quantitative revolution, it uses statistical methods and mathematical techniques and theorems, okay? Now, like all the other sciences, in the geography as well, the statistical method was used for generating and testing hypotheses using the empirical data. Okay, so it was basically, we can say, it was used to make estimates, while the mathematical techniques and theorems, they were used to derive models, okay, from a set of initial abstract assumptions. So from the initially assumed points or views, we used to derive the models by using the mathematical techniques. So we can simply say that the mathematical model, it used or it helped in testing the significance of various parameters. Okay, so they were used for making assumptions. Statistical methods were used for making assumptions, while the mathematical techniques, that they were used for testing the significance or authenticity of any assumption, okay? Now, if you look at back at the history of geography, we will see that there was a confusion amongst the geographer and the public mind about the nature and social relevance of geography, okay? Like other sciences, the geographers were not able to explain the significance of the geography in the field of regular life of people. Okay, so because of that, what happened during the Second World War, especially during the time of Second World War, the status of geography as a university discipline, it came under discussion. And after a long discussion, or a long debate, we can say, James Conant, he was the president of Harvard University, he reportedly came to the conclusion that the geography was not a subject of university. Okay, and soon after, we can see that in Harvard University, the department of geography was closed. Now, because the department of geography was closed in Harvard University, so there were no restrictions on the discipline and there were no parameters. So the parameters of this discipline were eased out, and because of this, the discipline of geography, it gained a lot of attention in the private universities of USA. And this led to great research in the field of geography in American universities, and this led to evolution of new ideas and research programs. Now, because of this, there was a development of special science school, which was also known as quantitative revolution in geography. So this quantitative revolution, it developed as an idea of special science school in American university. Okay, so this was during the period of Second World War, after Second World War, we can say. Now, we will see that during the time when this debate was going on, the geographers, they were not able to explain the philosophy, the nature, the methodology of geography. That was because of that, they suffered various complexes, that they did not have any standard theories, models and law like other sciences and social sciences and biological sciences. And they also felt that their researches, they were not considered of much social relevance. So what quantitative revolution exactly did, it actually overcame these complexes, and quantitative revolution helped in putting the subject into sound theoretical footing. And because of this, the geographers, they started to use this quantitative technique in interpreting the organization of space, in generalizing or formulating new theories and models about man and environment and their relationship, their interrelation. Okay, so all these things, they were developed by the help of quantitative revolution. Now, if you look at the main objectives of the quantitative revolution in geography, we will see that its first objective is to change the descriptive character of geography into a scientific one. Okay, so we will see that it tried to change geography, that is study of Earth, into a discipline that analyzes various parameters of Earth by using various mathematical techniques, quantitative techniques, etc. Okay, so this was the first objective, and this is the most important objective. Okay, it was the main, or we can say the base of development of quantitative revolution. Okay, next is to explain and interpret the spatial pattern of geographical phenomena. So this quantitative revolution, it tried to explain and interpret the spatial patterns of geography. into a rational objective, this quantitative revolution, it tried to explain various geographical phenomena and their spatial pattern in a very rational manner, in an objective manner, which can be understood by all, like not only geographer but also a common public. Okay. Now, the next objective was to use mathematical language. Now, mathematical language does not mean that we will use these symbols, etc. But it exactly means we will use some scientific pattern, or we will try to explain the concept in scientific pattern. Like we can see in the Köppen's classification of climate, we will see that various climates, they were explained or they were classified in the form of like AF, B, etc. So these type of languages should be used in geography instead of this language of literature. Okay. Next is to make precise statement about the location order. So about any location, we can give a generalization of, or we can generalize, or we can do generalization of any site. Okay. That was the another objective. Next is to test the hypothesis and formulate model theories and laws for estimation and prediction. So as we have studied, we have seen that the quantitative technique was used for testing the hypothesis, and the mathematical technique was used for formulation of models, theories and laws. So this is also an objective of quantitative revolution. Statistical technique was used for testing the hypothesis, whereas the mathematical techniques, they were used for formulating models, theories and laws. Okay. Next is to identify the ideal location for various economic activities. So during this time, we can see this was a period of industrialization. So for ideal location, so the industrialists, they actually wanted an ideal location for establishment of industry so that their profit can be maximized by using the resources of that area. And in our further lecture in economic geography, we will see the industrial location theory, etc. Here in these theories, they gave the industrialists some methods and some techniques to find the ideal location for setting up an industry. Okay. So this was all the objective of quantitative revolution. And the last objective of quantitative revolution is to make methodology of geography an objective and scientific one. Okay. So it tried to make geography a scientific discipline, okay, by giving it or by providing it some philosophical and theoretical basis. Okay, so these are the main objectives of quantitative revolution. Now, there were various assumptions that were made for formulation of models and theories. So some of the assumptions are, first is man is a rational person. Okay, so he basically is concerned about economy. Okay, so he is a rational person and he always try to optimize his profits. Okay, so he will try his best to maximize its profit. So he was this quantitative revolution, it considered man as materialistic one. Okay, so the person or the industrialist will not have any feeling, no no moral values or humanistic aspect will affect his decision. Okay. Next is, he has an infinite knowledge of space. So whatever, wherever the person is working, he will have all the knowledge about the space or the place where he is working. Now, next is, space is an isotropic surface. So space is basically the environment and resources. So space is isotropic surface. That means the distribution of resources and distribution of everything is homogeneous in all of the area. Okay. So they consider space as an isotropic surface. Next is, there is no place for normative questions. That means there is no space for normative questions, that is the questions that are related to social values, humanistic values. So they have no place in quantitative revolution, and this quantitative revolution is solely based on scientific research and objective interpretation of the geographical realities. Okay, so the normative questions, they were neglected. Okay, lastly, it focused on scientific explanation of geographical patterns. Okay, so the normative assumptions like cultural values, beliefs, attitudes, custom, traditions, they were given no place in geographical research. So the whole and sole focus of the quantitative revolution was on scientific explanation of each and every geographical pattern. Okay, so these were the assumptions that were made for formulation of any model or theory in the quantitative revolution. Now next we have is merits of quantitative method or quantitative revolution. First is, this quantitative revolution is based on empirical observation and they are readably verifiable. Okay, so each and everything that is put into quantitative revolution, it is based on the observation. Okay, so it is not an assumption, or we can say it does not have any normative aspect in its observation. So it can easily be verified. Okay, next is, the statistical method, they help in reducing multitude of observation data and facts to a manageable number of factors. Okay, so by the help of quantitative technique, we can reduce the number or the quantity of observation data and facts into manageable number. Okay, next is, it helps in estimation, interpolation, stimulation of data which are necessary for forecasting. Okay, then we can see this technique also helps in estimation, sorry, not estimation, it also helps in describing, analyzing and simplifying the geographical system. Okay, like for example, in the locational theory of industries, we can see that the land use in intensity, the stage of development of landforms, they can be easily explained and predicted by the help of quantitative techniques. So these locational theories we will study in our next lectures of economic geography. So in these theories, we will see that the quantitative revolution, it helps in understanding and predicting the whole concept. Okay, then this quantitative method, it provides a framework within a theoretical statement that can be formally presented. Okay, so it gives a framework where we can present our statements or our observations, whatever we have analyzed, these statements in a formal manner, which helps in this formal presentation of data. It helps in clear presentation, clear representation of the observations, which helps us in regional generalization. Okay, it, because we have clarity about the theoretical statement, that's why we are able to generalize or simplify the data. Okay, then as we have already studied, it helps in objective management of data, and at last it provides geography a sound philosophical, scientific and methodological base. Okay, so it helps in providing geography a scientific, philosophical and methodological base, because it is generally free from any biasness, and therefore it is used for building theories, generals and special laws. Okay, and also this quantitative technique, it helps in separating the geography from any sort of metaphysical or religious aspects. Okay, so these are the merits of quantitative revolution. If you look at the demerits of quantitative revolution, so in the demerits of quantitative revolution, we will see, first one is, this quantitative method, it is based on the philosophy of positivism. Okay, that means it is free from any sort of religious or metaphysical biases. Okay, so this positivism, this philosophy of positivism, it distinguishes science, this geographical science, from the religious and metaphysical biases, and because of it, the subject of geography, we can say it is simply reduced to subject of space geometry. So in this space geometry, we can only use our mathematical techniques and quantitative methods for deriving theories for industrial location, etc. But the relation between the environment and man, they are not established. This quantitative revolution is not able to establish the relationship between man and environment. Okay, because it is lacking the concept of metaphysics, etc. Okay, next is the language of geometry, which was advocated by quantitative revolution, was not an acceptable language to explain geography. Okay, because the relationship between the man and environment cannot be established or cannot be explained by this language of geometry or language of mathematics. And because the relationship between man and environment cannot be established, then the concept of or the subject of human geography is totally eliminated by this quantitative method. Okay, next is quantitative revolution, it focuses on locational analysis. Okay, so it only focuses on locational analysis, like how can we establish an industry so that it can gain the maximum profit. So all these things are focused in quantitative revolution, which promotes capitalism. Okay, so the capitalism is promoted in the quantitative revolution, which leads to exploitation of both human resource as well as environmental resources, that is natural resources. And because of this, the rich, they are getting richer, and the poor, they are getting poorer. Okay, the next demerit is there is less scope of employment. So there is less scope of employment in this quantitative method, because the quantitative method, because it tries to maximize the profit. So the industrialists, they try to use machinery for faster result and accurate result. Okay, so the employment for poor and non-industrial people is less, okay, because of which there is less scope of employment in quantitative method. Now after that we will see that there was a assumption in quantitative revolution that man is a rational person. So this assumption of man as a rational person who is materialistic and he tries to optimize his profit, it has been criticized, because in real world, if we see that the decision of location or selecting the location, they are not only influenced by profit maximization, but also we can see that there are various humanistic aspects that lead to influence the location of any industry. Okay, next is, there was a assumption in quantitative revolution that man has infinite knowledge about his space. So this is not possible. Man does not have infinite knowledge about his space and environment, because the knowledge about the space, it changes or it increases with the development of technology. Okay, so as our technology will develop, we will develop the knowledge, or we will increase the knowledge that we have about the space. Like for example, initially solar energy that we have, sun, was a source of light and heat for Earth, but after the development of technology, we were able to trap the heat energy from sun, and we were able to generate the electricity from solar energy. Now when furthermore our technology will develop, we may also be able to develop various things from solar energy. So with the development of our knowledge, the development of the knowledge of space also increases. Okay, next is, see, quantitative technique, it actually, sorry for the disturbance. Now we can see that this application of quantitative technique, it demands not only mathematical techniques or mathematical formulas, etc., it also requires a reliable data. Now this reliable data is not available for each and every geographical area or each and every space. Okay, like there are few countries which are developed, so they will have the geographical data or they will have the reliable data, but there are some other countries which are developing or which are underdeveloped, so they will not have a readily available data for each and every geographical area. Okay, so if the geographical the data is not available for geographical area, the people will try to collect the data for developing countries, but the data collection in the developing countries, it has various pitfalls and shortcomings, because of which the data that is collected is not reliable, it is not fully reliable. So the models or theories that will be developed from this data, this faulty data, will also be faulty. Okay, they will also give a distorted or faulty picture of the geographical reality. The next is, this quantitative revolution, it uses various complicated and sophisticated techniques for proving or for formation or for development of any model. So this estimation of or prediction, they are proved erroneous many of times. Okay, so many times this estimation and predictions, they are proved faulty, and because of this, the model that are prepared, they are also faulty. And because of this, faulty depiction of geographical area, there is a danger of overgeneralization of the facts. Okay, so this quantitative revolution may lead to overgeneralization of the fact. This is one of the most important demerit. Then last one is making reliable models and universal laws. They are not possible in a quantitative revolution, because for making reliable laws and models, we basically require a reliable data. So the data collected, when the process of data collection is faulty, or the estimation and predictions, they are proved erroneous, then the laws and models which are made, they are also not reliable. So like other sciences, in quantitative revolution, we do not have any possibility of making reliable laws or models. As we can see that the model developed in this scientific or the statistical technique, they give more prominence to some features and they distort some others. Okay, so because of this, the data or the laws that are made, they are not very reliable, and they are not possibly, we can say that it is not possible to make a universal law from quantitative revolution. So this was basically about quantitative revolution. So that was all for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed today's lecture. Let's meet in our next class. Till then, take care and have a nice day. Thank you.